Hello everyone, this is Professor M.S. Goite, Assistant Professor of Department of Agricultural Entomology, KKPA College of Agricultural Entomology, and our today's topic is Biological Control or Biological Control Agents, their ideal characteristics under the course number ENTO 365, that is Management of Beneficial Insect. Let us see the biocontrol agents, are also called as natural enemies. In today's lecture, we will see the introduction of bioagents, and second is ideal characteristics of the bioagents. So firstly, what is the meaning of biological control? So the biological control or biocontrol is a method of controlling the pests such as insect, mites, weeds and plant diseases using other organism. Our second definition is biological control has been defined simply as utilization of natural enemies to reduce the damage caused by the noxious organism to tolerable level. So these are the two different definition of the biological control or biocontrol. Then next is the introduction of bioagent. So the biological control agents are the living organism including the parasite, then predators and disease causing fungi as well as bacteria and viruses. These are the natural enemies of the pest which can intervene the life cycle of the insect pest in a such a way that the crop damage is minimized. They are both less toxic and more flexible than the chemical pesticide. Biological control includes a wide range of approaches from natural predators to biological produce molecules. Microorganisms including the viruses, bacteria, fungi and protozoan cause a disease or poison their targets through the toxin production, and these bioagents can be conserved, preserved and multiply under the laboratory condition for the field release. Once these bioagents are introduced in the field to build their population considerably, they are capable of bringing down the targeted pest population below the economic threshold level. Among all the pest management techniques, the microbial agents are most effective in controlling the target insect pest and require appropriate formulation and application. So this is the introduction of or about the bioagents. Then next topic is the different ideal characteristics of bioagents or natural enemies. So first characteristics is narrow host range. So they have the narrow host range. Generalized predators make good natural enemies, but they don't kill the inner pest when other types of prey are also available. So the bioagents have the narrow host range. Then second characteristics is climatic adaptability. So it should be adapted to varied environmental condition and survive in all habitats of the pest. Natural enemies must be able to survive the extremes of temperature and also the humidity that will encounter in the new habitat. Then third characteristics is synchrony with the host, that is prey life cycle. The predator or parasite should be present when the pest first emerges or appears. Then next is high reproductive potential. Good biological or biocontrol agent produce a large number of offspring, and ideally a parasite completes more than one generation during each year. Then next characteristics is efficient search ability. In order to survive, effective natural enemies must be able to locate their host or prey even when it is scarce. In general, better search ability results in a lower pest population densities. The next characteristics is short handling time. Natural enemies that consume prey rapidly or lay eggs quickly have more time to locate and attack other members of the pest population. Then small population of efficient natural enemies may be more effective biocontrol agents than larger population of less efficient species. The next is survival at a low cost. Pre-density or host density. If a natural enemy is too efficient, it may eliminate its own food supply and then starve to death. The most effective biocontrol agent reduces pest population below its economic threshold and then maintain it at this lower equilibrium level. Next is a fast multiplication. Multiply faster than the host, short life cycle with high fecundity and high female male ratio. So these are the different characteristics of the bioagent or the natural enemies. Then also the easy reading and mass multiplication or culturing in a laboratory, then disperse quickly in a locality, then it should be free from hyperparasites, then it should not harmful to other beneficial species and plant species, it should withstand refrigeration, and it should be small and tiny. So these are the different ideal characteristics of natural enemies. Thank you so much.